Hello friends, thank you so much for taking this video. I'm Sunday, and in this journey, I'm going to be showing you how I sketched this awesome booth. You can see, this is an awesome booth that was made in the workshop in here by a student. And the student was engaged for a two-month program, and they were, at the point of finishing this program, we were able to make this awesome booth out. So this was a sample booth for a project for a client. We'll sketch it out, how we arrive at a usable drawing of the last is what I will be showing you in this video. I do this from A to Z, so join me to see how I sketch this house, giving all reference to all the details of this project. Starting with this. This is an offline sketching. What you mean by an offline sketching is the sketching at which you don't need to sketch on the last. What you need to do on the last is that you need to get a side base of the last out. Once you get it out, then you draw with that on its flat base, which is on a paper, on a two base, then you draw it and you represent all sections of the project you want to do on the paper. The exact way it's looking right in there is what you're meant to draw on the flat base, putting in consideration the frame of the last you're using, and the sizes too matters a lot. So after you've gotten the frame out, for full details about how to get this frame out, please check the this. I have a video like that on this platform that's going to help you out in achieving the frame of a last. And while you have achieved the frame of the last, we then do everything based on measurement. You need to do everything based on measurement so it can be accurate and it can look at exact of what you want to draw. This project, I'm not just designing a new thing, I'm making a complete prototype of a booth. So working on a booth, putting a set of students all through how to achieve a German high top boot, military boot. So we just draft it out. And remember, this is a sketch. This is not a drawing. A sketch is you're allowed to have a multiple stripes on this sketching. So your pencil can go multiple times because you're not so sure. And so you're not so sure of the drawing, so you just have to sketch it, balance it, time you have what is looking like what you have on the screen, not just what you have, but what you look like, what you want to achieve at. And again, I'm going to be emphasizing on it, the measurement is very, very important. You need to clean up, you need to readjust. If you adjust, your drawing is not getting balanced, not looking at what you want to get, what you're drawing, the prototype of what you're working on, then you need to keep adjusting it. So once you're adjusting it, I'm so sure you're gonna get it just like that. I'm getting my house right now. You're definitely going to get it out. The section that is not a need, that is not making your project look like what you have in there, you just need to clean it up and you have to take note of details. All sections, detailing is very, very important. The point you have an highlight, you have to remember to add in the highlight. The portion you have a hole, you have a joining, the overlapping joining, you indicate the overlapping joining, the measurement of each sections. Because you're working with the prototype, you should be able to, you will not be able to get the accurate measurement, but because it's a soft copy, you cannot measure it accurately, but you definitely get able to guess what is definitely going to be a bit close to it. So remember, this is an offline pattern sketching drawing out. So at this point, it is very important to add up what is going to be under the base of the last, under the base of the last, equivalent to a lasting alarm. So after you add it up to 8, the next phase we're going now is to then come to start cutting this out. You need to cut this out of what you've sketched, because each section of this project needs to be cut out. But you can't just piece everything out. You have to cut it out in full. So we are cutting it out in full right now. Cut it out, and at the time we have this cut out, we are done. Presently, we are done with the project. We are just cutting it out so we can have a room to use this to transform to our usable pattern. This is not yet a usable pattern. We've just been able to draw this out. So the next phase we are going to now is to then transform this to usable pattern. You can see it's looking exactly like what we have on the screen. So come with me right now to start to go to the next phase, which is the transforming of this to a usable pattern, representing each part of each section of this on a different board.
Thank you so much for watching this time. Hope you like what you've seen. What you just need to do is that you've seen the way I sketch this out. So after I sketch it, the next thing I'm going to be doing right now is to transform this sketching right in here to be ready to use pattern. What you're going to be using to cut out the project on display, and once you cut it out, we will then move on to the making process of it. Thank you so much for joining me before to have you in my subscribe to button. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Subscribe so whenever I release the completed version of this project, you can identify. Look what I'm doing.